Hello all. In last video, we replicated this pivot table structure to our pandas data frame. I will just do a quick recap what this data set is. So basically, we have filtered our Airbnb New York City data set for Manhattan neighborhood group. And in that, we formulated this pivot table in that the very first column is neighborhoods. Second column is number of hosts for that particular neighborhoods. And also the average price. All right, and entire data set is sorted by number of hosts in descending order. Okay, now our objective is to plot this line chart based on this data. So we already have this data set now here in the data frame. So I will just use head to. Okay, now in order to plot this line chart, I will simply grab the code which we have for stack chart. Okay, and we'll simply edit that code. Okay, as of now I will comment all these things, and since we have to plot only one chart, line chart, I will delete these two guys as well. And now, so instead of bar, so we don't have to plot a bar chart, but we have to plot a line chart. So there is a separate class to plot a line chart. And that class is this plot. Okay, I will change this, and also these parameters also gets changed. Okay, so let's look at the parameters. So these are a few examples, x and y. Okay, and this is for, as you can see here, using blue circle markers, but we'll check that. So let's look at the parameters which this plot constructor accepts. So the very first parameter, most important parameter, is x and y coordinates. That is array like or scalars. Okay, so you can either pass array or the scalar value. Okay, now what would be the x axis if I plot a line chart? So let's go back here. So over here, as you can see, the x axis is nothing but the neighborhood names. Okay, now in our data frame, as you can see here, if I want to get these neighborhood names, either I have to go with the index. So if I use like index, I can still get the neighborhood names. But what I will do, instead of taking neighborhood name from index, I will reset the index. What I mean is, I will get this default index, and I will move that neighborhood column as a I will move that neighborhood index as a column. Okay, so I will change that in original data frame. Okay, and let me add it here. Okay, and let's print this guy again. Okay, so this is fine. Now our objective is to find out x-axis, which is nothing but the neighborhood names. How can I do that? So if I use dot loc, I need all the rows but only one column, and that column is neighborhood. I will get the series, and that is what we are looking for. So I'll copy this guy here, and let's say I will use head 2. Okay, so I will copy this guy, and I will pass that as a x-axis. Okay, what is my y-axis? So in this case, y-axis is nothing but number of hosts. How will I get the number of hosts? It's simple. So instead of neighborhood groups, I just have to, okay, let me print this guy again. So we got neighborhood groups. I just need a host ID now, value of host ID, which is nothing but the second column. So I will simply copy this guy, and I will change the column name, that is host underscore ID. We don't need a width because it's not a bar chart. Okay, I don't know whether it needs a color attribute, whether it accepts the color attributes. We'll check in the documentation. So data, and looks like it doesn't accept color attribute. Let's search color. Yeah, it does accept. We'll see. Let's run this guy, and I will change this label as, so my label is, so this is number of host. It worked. All right, and it did change the color to blue. Now the problem is, since we have too many neighborhoods, okay, it's not getting fit in the original image. What I need to do if I want to increase the width of this image? So there is another class for it. So if you look at this particular class called figure under same hierarchy, pyplot interface, it accepts parameter called fix size. We'll look at, we'll check that. So let me first call this guy. So what I will do before plotting our actual plot, we'll call this class and I will pass parameter as fix size. So it accepts, so default is none, and it accepts two parameters, width and height, okay, in inches. What I will do, I'll pass this guy equal to, okay, and let's say width is 18 and height is 6. Yeah, this looks much better. But still, if you can see my x-axis, these names got overlapped on each other. So one thing we can do is we can change the, or if you can rotate those labels or x-axis labels, it may appear much better. Okay, so how can I rotate those x-axis? So there is other class called xtex. Okay, and if you can see here, that class accepts parameter called rotation. Okay, so let me call that as well, PLTX, and I will call, I'll rotate that. So this is the angle which you are defining. So I will change that to, let's say, 40. Now if I see, yes, now it's readable. Okay, now you can identify the names of particular neighborhoods. Another thing which I want to do is, I really cannot figure out the value of that particular x and y-axis basically. Still, even for x-axis also we cannot figure out. So I will add grids on top of it. And in this particular case, I need both x and y grids. So I will just delete it. By default, it prints both the grids, x and y. Yeah. Looks much better now. Okay, now at least I can understand for Manhattan this is more than 2000. So this basically the host count. So what I need is, I also need a legend, because this really cannot tell me what this line signifies. So I will remove that. Yeah, so number of host, now it is much better. Let me add label as well. So on y-axis, it's a number of hosts. As of for time being, I will. Okay, let's change that. Number of, or count of hosts, or number of hosts. Okay, x-axis is nothing but neighborhood. And title is number of host by neighborhood. So I will simply copy this guy. Yeah, this looks much better. Okay, but there is another thing. If you look at our original Excel thing, over here we have two different charts. Okay, we have another chart by average price as well. Okay, so if I want to add another line chart for average price, what I need to do, I will just copy this the way we did for stack chart. So we basically we added three different bar charts. Okay, so similar way we'll add two different line charts. Okay, so I will just change the column name here, and that column is price, and I will give color as red. Okay, and label as average price. Yeah, now it looks better. Okay, only one thing is now I need to remove this label because this is not only the y-axis doesn't signify only the host, it also signifies the average price. Okay, so I will remove this guy. Yeah. Yes, now it looks better. Alright, so basically we covered number 14. Alright, so in last video we prepared the data set and this video we created a line chart. Okay, thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video.